Hey everyone, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are talking about P0135 fault codes. A P0135 code is going to read out as oxygen sensor heater circuit malfunction, and it might also say bank 1 sensor 1, which is referring to the upstream oxygen sensor on the bank 1 side of the engine. Now, this error code points to an issue with the oxygen sensor, but it points more specifically to the heater circuit that's located within the oxygen sensor, and that gets a little bit more technical than just speaking about oxygen sensors themselves. So to better understand what causes a P0135 and what the actual problem is with your oxygen sensor, let's go ahead and talk just briefly about how oxygen sensors work, what the heater circuit element is, and then from there we'll go ahead and talk about the most common causes of P0135 fault codes, and I'll give you a quick diagnostic checklist that you can walk through to help nail down what the issue is that's causing this problem. So oxygen sensors basically read the amount of oxygen that's in your exhaust gas before it passes through the catalytic converter and then after it passes through the catalytic converter. The whole purpose of them is to determine how efficient your catalytic converter is to make sure that it's working properly and reducing emissions like it's supposed to. So ultimately, they measure the efficiency of your emission systems to make sure that they're up to par and working like they should. Now, these oxygen sensors read the amount of oxygen in the air, which is a basic idea, but how you actually read oxygen in air is a little bit more complex, and it requires a chemical reaction to take place. The chemical reaction that takes place to actually measure the amount of oxygen only takes place at extremely high temperatures, usually over 600 degrees in Fahrenheit. And so for your oxygen sensor to work properly, it needs to have an internal temperature of over 600 degrees Fahrenheit. Otherwise, the chemical reaction won't take place. Of course, your exhaust gases aren't always going to be at 600 plus degrees, and in some vehicles, they might never get that high. So an oxygen sensor has inside it what's called a heating circuit, and what that does is it heats up the inside of the oxygen sensor to get it above that 600 degree temperature so that the chemical reaction takes place. And so when we see this P0135 fault code that says that there is an issue with the heater circuit, it's referring to that internal component of the oxygen sensor and basically saying that we have an issue with the oxygen sensor getting up to the temperature that it needs to get up to for it to work properly. So to break down a P0135 a little bit further in terms of the functionality of an oxygen sensor, we basically have a 12 volt power supply or electricity coming from the battery that gets sent into the oxygen sensor that then causes it to heat up. When we have an issue with the heater circuit or with the oxygen sensor not getting hot enough, there's really only two things that could take place. The first one is the oxygen sensor is not getting the electricity that it needs to heat up, and so we've got an electrical issue with it not getting power. And then the second issue is it just has a bad heater element inside of it, and it just can't or won't get hot enough because the oxygen sensor itself is defective. So ultimately, it's a wiring problem or it's the sensor itself. I did a video recently on a P0030 fault code, and a P0030 is what you're gonna get when the vehicle detects that it's actually not sending electrical current to the oxygen sensor. So when you get a P0135, if you don't have a P0030 along with it, that generally means that the oxygen sensor is receiving voltage and electrical current. It's just not getting up to that high temperature, which means the issue is inside the oxygen sensor. 99% of the time, you're just gonna need to replace the oxygen sensor because there really is no way of repairing the oxygen sensor itself. You just have to go and replace it. But with that being said, one of the common causes of a P0030 with the oxygen sensor not getting current is something as simple as a blown fuse. So like I mentioned, with a P0135, you probably have an okay electrical current flowing to the sensor. It's usually gonna be the sensor itself, but oxygen sensors can get expensive, and it is possible in certain circumstances where you get a P0135, but you don't get a P0030, even though you have an electrical problem. So before you go ahead and replace the oxygen sensor, I'd recommend looking at your fuse box and making sure you don't have a blown fuse, because if it's something as simple as a blown fuse, that is a 50 cent fix rather than an oxygen sensor, which a lot of times are $100, $150+. So pull your fuse diagram and look for the oxygen sensors on there. Usually that'll read out something like O2HS, O2HTR, or ENGSENS. Go ahead and check the fuse, pull the fuse out for it. If the fuse is good, then that means your oxygen sensor is the problem. And that's really all there is to a P0135 engine code. Now, it is relatively safe or okay to drive with this engine code popping up, but it is important to understand that the readings that oxygen sensors give are also relayed back to the engine's computer, and they're actually used to calculate how much fuel or how much air needs to be sent into the combustion chamber. So in certain circumstances, if you have a bad oxygen sensor, you might be getting a rough idle, sluggish or hesitant acceleration, and a number of other performance related issues, along with very poor fuel economy. Because this is an emissions component and because it's something that affects how your vehicle runs, it is important to replace it quickly, but if you do need to drive around with the engine code out, as long as your symptoms coming from the engine aren't too bad, then that's not the worst thing in the world. That covers it on our video on P0135 fault codes. I hope this was helpful in diagnosing the problem that you have going on with your vehicle. If you found this video helpful, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future content.